Hey friends, in this video, I want to show you a small test project that utilizes the RF24Network library. With its help, we have 5 NRF24L01 modules connected to ESP32 controllers, forming a radio network. The goal of this test is to assess the functionality of the radio network in a multi-story building, to determine if such communication can be used for building a smart home system. So, I've assembled 5 devices for this purpose. For the foundation, I've chosen 5 ESP32 mini boards and 5 NRF24 radio modules. Each microcontroller is connected to LEDs for device status indication, and there's also a button to toggle the device's state in the network. All the boxes are logically synchronized to demonstrate and test the interconnection between devices in a smart home. Powering the boxes with a 5 volts voltage is possible either through a micro USB cable or a DC jack. Alright, now that we've covered the basics, let's dive into the details of this exciting project. The electrical schematic of one such device is as follows. U1 represents the ESP32 mini board. The radio module is connected to it via the SPI bus. The 3.3 volts power supply is also provided by the controller. Additionally, we have the SW1 button and LEDs D1, D5, each with its respective resistors R1, R5. J1 represents the DC power jack. The block diagram of the network shows the base station with the address 00 and the connected stations with addresses 1, 2, 3, and 4. The block diagram of the network shows the base station with the add-in a smart home scenario. There could be dozens of these devices. To build such a network, I relied on the RF24Network library, which claims the ability to connect up to 3,125 NRF24 modules into a network. As evident from this diagram, the network architecture allows for signal amplification from distant module stations. However, if any of the node stations fail, there will be a loss of communication with the entire cluster positioned further down the hierarchy. Alright, now that we have a clear understanding of the hardware and network structure, let's move on. The library's description and various versions for different systems can be found on GitHub. You can also download the library files for working with the Arduino IDE and find examples of using the library there. I will show you how to install it using the Arduino IDE Library Manager. In the Library Manager window, enter the search phrase NRF24Network, then simply click on the Install button next to the Library by Avamonder. After installation, you can find several ready-made sketches in the examples. Let's take a look at the Hello World RX example, which demonstrates how to receive data from the base station with address 0 while being a station with address 1. And here is my sketch on the left for the base station with address 0. These are the pin numbers to which the CE and CSN pins of the radio module are connected. Here are the addresses of all the stations in the network. The setup function contains the configuration for the NRF24 module and the pins to which the LEDs and button are connected. In this part of the master sketch, incoming messages containing the LED states are read. The master station also duplicates this state to all the subordinate stations in the network. Here is the code for controlling the LEDs based on the value of the angle value variable. And here is the code for handling button presses. When the button is pressed, the angle value variable is incremented by 1, and its new value is sent to all slave stations in the network. On the right side of the screen, we have the Node 1 sketch. Here are the pin numbers for CE and CSN. We also have the station addresses in the radio network. In this part of the sketch, data is read from the master and LEDs control is performed. Here, button presses are tracked, and the LED state stored in the angle value variable is changed. The new value is then sent to the master controller with address 0. and here, you can see the three remaining sketches, which differ in their network addresses. We upload these five sketches to the five controllers and obtain the following result. The network is built on a hierarchical tree-like system. One of the five boxes represents the base station. If it is disconnected or malfunctions, all the other stations will operate independently. I'm disabling the slave. The remaining devices in the network continue to work synchronously. Now I'm disabling the master, and each device works independently. The network is disrupted due to the absence of a node station. I'm reconnecting the master, and the network is restored. With this setup, you can test the quality and reliability of communication by placing the boxes in different locations around the house. Through experimentation, it was determined that such communication within a building on a single floor works reasonably well. However, communication between floors is poor. On one floor, the distance between devices should not exceed 25 meters. Using the RF24 network library, it is possible to build wireless components for a smart home, but ensuring good communication between them is crucial. Address allocation to the modules needs to be done thoughtfully. In some cases, it may be necessary to use radio modules with amplifiers and good antennas. It is even advisable to incorporate such enhancements into the node stations of the network from the very beginning. I encourage you to replicate and further develop my endeavors, and please share your experiences in the comments. Thank you for your likes and subscribing to the channel. See you soon.